foremost. I want to give all honors and praises and glory. Belongs to my Lord and Savior, whose name is Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Wahavah Kakadash. The name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh, and his Son's name is Yahweh Shai. And he we reverence and honors to the elder apostles of great millstone that taught me this truth, okay, and to the hopeful elect across the globe, and to the few, the very few brothers and sisters listening and learning in the hopes of being saved within these last days. All right, it's going to be straight to the point, and we're going to go to Matthew 21 and 13. This is Matthew 21 and start at 11. And the multitude said, "This is Yahweh Shai, the prophet of Nazareth of Galilee." And Yahweh Shai went into the temple of the Most High. Because back then, where was the main place of worship? The temples, which is also known as what? Synagogues. Okay? And casting all them out that sold and bought in the temple. So Yahweh Shai was not really pleased with certain individuals. Okay, he cast them out. He was angry. Okay? That bought in the temple and overthrew the tables of the money changers. You had those who were using, okay, that temple that adds a way to what? Make merchandise, which is what? Money. And when you go into that word money changer, and back then it was what? A coin dealer, okay, which they would mint particular coins back then, okay, and they would what? Sometimes they would manipulate the weight so they can make a bit more money. Okay, this is what they were doing. They were defrauding the people. They were using Yahweh and his temple as a way of what? As corruption. Okay, this is what they were doing. And overthrew the tables of the money changers and seats of them that sold doves. So Yahweh was very, 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 very zealous. Okay, he was very zealous for the truth. And these individuals, they were not about truth, they were about gain. And this is what happens. Money, wherever money is, a load of money is to be made, there's corruption, you will find corruption. And he said unto them, "It is written, my house shall be a house of prayer, shall be called a house of prayer." And that's what it is, to worship Yahweh Shai, not to make gain. See, there's a difference. If a brother gives you something, you know, some money, tithing, that's completely something different. That's lawful. But to go to the temple to make gain, and there's a reason why they were in the temple, because that's where the majority of people would be. There was money to be made. And wherever the masses are, there's money to be made. So these were, again, the chief priests and Pharisees doing some more wicked stuff. And that's why Yahweh Shai said, beware of what? The wolves in sheep's clothing. They are ravening wolves. Okay? Oh, man. So it's a house of prayer. Prayer addressed to the Most High. A place set apart or suited for the offering of prayer. Synagogue. A place in the open air where the Jews were wont to pray outside. All the cities where they had a certain hour. Such places were situated upon the bank of a stream or the shore of the sea, where there was a supply of water for washing hands before prayer. Right? So now let's go back to where you were. But you have made it a den of thieves. But you have made it a den of thieves. A den of thieves. So they were thieves. They were taken from the people. Okay? And the blind and the lame came to him in the temple, and he healed them. Yahweh Shai healed them. And that was the major thing. See, these Pharisees, they were not there to heal you. They were there to keep you in bondage. That's why the scripture says, "And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free." A lot of these Pharisees, they had the people under bondage. They were not healing anyone. They were not healing anyone. Right? They were just extracting things from them. Alright? And the blind and lame came into the temple and he healed them. When the chief priests and the scribes saw the wonderful things that he did, the children crying in the temple and saying, Hosanna to the Son of David. And that's a proclamation of what praises to what Yahweh saying. They were saw this peace. So the Pharisees, they were envious. Right? And said unto him, here is though what he say, and Yahweh said unto them, yeah, have you ever read? Out of the mouth of babes, okay, young ones, and sucklings that have perfected praise. Okay? And then he left them and went out of the city of into the city indefinitely and lodged. Yeah, so Yahweh Shabbat is getting them. He's very, 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 very confrontational. Because he knew they weren't not right. And it's the same thing again today. Let's go to Micah 3 and 11. The heads therefore judge for rewards. Oh man. Oh man, it says the heads. So who are the heads? The heads are what? Elders. The heads are the chief priests. When are they heads? The heads were Pharisees. It's telling you they judge for rewards, for money, for gain. Okay? So that means that they're not really doing things through the Holy Spirit. They judge for gain, they judge for rewards. They're compromised. And the priests, they were peach for hire. Okay? You know what that reminds me of? It's the same thing with the churches. The churches do the same thing. If there's money involved, well, yeah, they're motivated. And if money's your motivation when it comes to this truth, you ain't going to last long. You're going to have any integrity. You ain't going to want to teach. You're just going to be going to the camp. What? Your mind ain't going to be there. Because it's for money. If money's your motivation, then you're not going to be a prophet. You should be. Okay? And they teach for hire. And the scriptures, when you go to John 10, read John 10, it talks about the hire. The hireling ain't going to be diligent. The hireling ain't really going to care about the sheep. The hireling is a hireling. He's a mercenary. He's been hired by Esau. And that's where what the 503c1 charter comes in. We're going to go into that as well. And the prophets therefore divine for money. Just like the churches. They're divining just for money. Okay? And they're not even divining you truth. They're only giving you what? Part two. Okay? And for you to tell a lie, you have to know what part of the truth. Yet they will not lean upon the Lord Yahweh and Yahweh Shai. Because if you actually trusted in Yahweh Shai, you will know. Yahweh Shai will give you your daily bread. Okay? And is not the Lord Yahweh Shai among us? None evil can come upon us, but that evil is going to come upon you. Therefore shall Zion for your sake be proud as a field, and Jerusalem shall be become peaks, and the mountain of the house as the highest place of the the Lord's going to send what swift judgment, okay, to those that are doing it, right? And when you go into that word 501c3 charter also, that's what tax exemption, which it meets. Particular requirements are needed. So people that have taken this 501c3 charter, there's particular requirements from them, from the government, because it's the government that gives them that charter. And it's with what most of these organizations, okay? And they only give you that if you water down some things, okay? You don't really teach people all the truth. That's when you're given that. So that's a man, that's an individual that's been compromised, okay? That's why you're going to get into it, all these things. Let's go to Isaiah 56 and 10. His watchmen are blind. About in Isaiah 60, 61, I said, watchmen shall never hold their peace. But he said, these watchmen are blind. So yeah, this particular watchmen, they're blind. They can give you prophecy, but they're blind. Because they're not about Yahweh Shai. Right? They are all ignorant. Ignorant means iliakas in the Greek. To not know, to not want to know. They are all dumb. In other words, someone's dumb that can't speak. Okay? They are all dumb dogs. And dumb dogs, they cannot bark. So a dog, when someone's outside your premises, the dog's supposed to be barking to warn you. So these men are likened unto dumb dogs. Sleeping, lying down, loving to slumber. Okay? So they're idle. In other words, they're lukewarm. So a true servant of the Lord, to have a true prophet, he's not going to be lukewarm. Okay? loving to slumber. And when you go into that word slumber also, it goes into what? Being lukewarm, being slothful. And when you look at that word slothful, it's Ramaya. Slothful, remiss, deceitful, treacherous. So you've got a whole bunch of men in this truth that are treacherous. And was this lesson done with any malicious intent? No. It's done to warn you of what's happening. You've got certain people, once you've taken a bag, you're not going to have that same love that you had for the truth, because you've been given that bag. And that's why the scripture says a gift destroyeth the heart. So you're given a gift, yes, that destroys the heart. Now you're not really a true prophet. Now you're just like, you're a false prophet. Watering down the doctrine. Yeah, they are all greedy dogs. Greedy goes into what? Well, that's self-explanatory. Greedy. Greedy, man. Okay. Ravenous. Which can never have enough. They want more and more and more. It goes into covetousness. And they are shepherds. And they are shepherds that cannot understand. So you have shepherds over you, but they can't even understand. They don't even understand the 12 tribe chart. Okay. They don't even understand the Israelite foreigners. They all look to their own way. Okay, so if a man's going 4 or 5 days, he doesn't really give a shit, especially if he's a leader. Okay? Everyone for his own gain, because the carnal man, the worldly man's about gain. Worldly gain for him, from his quarter. Okay? Come ye say, Ray, I will fetch wine, and we will fill ourselves with strong drink, and more shall be as a day as much more abundant. So this is the mindset they have. This is the mindset of a false prophet. Okay? All about gain. All about the fame of this world. That's why you've got to separate yourself from this world. Because if you don't, guess what happens? This world will consume you. These are the things that will happen. Okay, Ben, just a minute. Be the prophet of the Most High, which is among you, taking an oversight, looking out, and you're feeding them with the right things, with the truth, what they need to know. Okay? Not by constraint, not holding back. You don't hold back anything. You don't hold back none of the doctrine, but willingly. So it takes a certain type of mind. You have to be willing, not for filthy lucre. There's that word, filthy lucre, which is gain. Some people come in this for money, selling breakdowns. Why are you selling breakdowns for? Selling garments. Why are you doing all that? Okay. Set up a PayPal account and get more subscribers so more people can pay. The truth was never for that. It was never for that. Okay. Which is among you, taking an oversight, not by constraint, but willingly, not for filthy lucre, for money. But of a ready mind. That's what you want to be in that lot, of having a ready mind. Okay? Neither as being lords of the Most High's heritage, not being a tyrant, but being examples unto the flock. Now, not a man can't even understand this. Okay? The scriptures tell us. Yahusha, he was flipping those tables within them synagogues. Can you imagine how they must have felt? But Yahusha had done that. Why? Because he was moved by what the spirit and power of Yahusha had shown. And it tells that in Psalms, what the zeal of my house had eaten me up. Okay? That was the true zeal. And zeal actually goes into what? Being covetous. So of course Yahusha was covetous for what? The Lord Yahusha, he's what? His temple. And that's why I know you have a spiritual temple, but the same thing is happening today with men. Do you really see? A lot of men, they insult your intelligence, but this is happening in the truth. Okay, and even Paul, was Paul helped out by the churches? Yes, but even Paul said he did not defraud no man, nor was he covetous for neither silver nor gold, but he was laboring with his own hands, and whatever was given to him, he was using that for the ministry. He was not using it for himself. Okay, so all the demonic men that are in the truth doing that, repent from that. The scriptures talk about defrauding. Have you ever read, the Lord's what? The Lord give us this daily bread. That's all you need. So So why would you make this piece a thing of what? Merchandise. That's why Yahweh is coming. When he comes back, he's coming to destroy a lot of men. Until the next time, Shalom.